I'm Carol Real. This is the National Archives Veterans Project. I'll be interviewing today Duane Aaron Harris. He was born on October 19, 1913. He resides at 4100 Moore's Lane, number 24, Texarkana, Texas. He served in World War II in the United States Army. Now you sit down in your chair and I'll get this thing ready to shoot. I'd love to interview Marshall, but I don't know. It's really a little bit better mind. Is that light on your head? Come on.
Yes.
Just about right. Okay, with that, you can relax and relax your neck and get really comfortable now. I'm going to see how you look.
Okay.
That looks good. That looks good. All right. Okay. Why don't you tell me about the branch of service that you served in, what your rank was, and where you served?
I served in the Field Artillery, in the European Theater of Operation. I was in the Field First Lieutenant, Field Major, and the Lieutenant First Lieutenant, and the
Okay, and you came out of the Texas A&M ROTC program, is that right?
Yes, I graduated from the Texas A&M Ambulance Commission as a lieutenant in 1935.
Okay. Well, I remember you telling me that at that time they still had very strong artillery, is that right?
Yes, we had the old American 3H. It was very strong, about 6 horses going in straight in.
Did you ever work with horses before you did that?
Yes, we did. I raised in a small town. We did very well. We had a horse. I learned papers on a horse.
Oh, okay. Okay, so the horse was not a big deal.
No.
Did you all have mules?
Yeah, right.
Did they have mules at A&M or just horses? Mules?
No, we had a lot of mules.
Just horses? Just horses.
We took riding lessons. We learned how to post on the ride.
So, after you left A&M, did you go directly into the service?
No, no. It was not my agency or anything. In 1919, I got out of work and I checked in my second lieutenant's report. So, they had the 3rd Army members in San Antonio in 1946 or 1948. I got a certificate, something made for the Board of Nations, playing at 3 million dollars out here in the world. I think the first player was a team, and since I was first returning, the vacancy came up and Barry me, and I was inside Barry. To sign Barry B and lost 2 hours for hours.
Yeah. You said you had a set of a gun. What kind of a gun were you setting up?
Well, survey officers. When you put in a position of survey officers, you get good enough, they have good enough for it. The survey officer gets out of the building sports and it gives them the fire relation to consider what you know about the S3, he's the operation officer. He reports to the air that he locks up four lungs of the battery.
Thank you.
artillery. Thank you. streaming because my life is at home and the world is crying. story. So I said, John, we were all sitting there ready to go. And they went to this call, and he said, well, I'm supposed to make next. I'm supposed to call next. Well, you know, David told him, so I'm ready to hear him. I said, well, come on.
racial thing?
Well, that went on. And we had four reasons why we had to have a little time to turn the best word on. Or our retirement would say, Johnny, we're right there. And we say it wrong. Well, I had no feedback or anything. I had a song. I had a thing in my head. All those things, you know,
say goodbye after that?
I will remember.
Just stuck out there all by yourself. Well, that's a long and good story. I hate to wind it up, but we are all out of time. And I appreciate you spending time. You were the shortest 6-foot-4 man I probably ever saw. Well, I tell you what, tomorrow's your 90th birthday, so we need to cut this off so you can get out.